Thank you. Please come.
Look at what you have delivered. Instead of delivering your promise of 2 crore jobs, that means 12 crore jobs by now, you have delivered the highest rate of unemployment in 45 years of India's history. In Tamil Nadu, there are highly educated 14 lakh people had applied for 10 sweeper jobs. Despite this grave situation of unemployment, I shocked to see that the finance minister have not uttered the word unemployment even once in his longest ever 2 hours 40 minutes budget speech. This the future of millions of youth at stake. It's paining me, but this is not bothering you. This government had single-handedly destroyed the MSME industries, which is the major source of employment. I am coming from the constituency of Karur, which is the fourth largest export in the country. We had a glorious past, but the disastrous decisions of twin decisions of demonetization and hastily implemented flawed GST has destroyed the backbone of the small businesses and industries. I have seen the pain in every day in my life. But this budget hasn't come up with any concrete measures, innovative solutions to revive the MSME sector and boost the economy. So I appreciate that they come with one line solution, which is to increase the audit limit from 1 crore to 5 crores. You promised to double the farmers' incomes, but there have been mass suicides of farmers. You have not waived the farmers' loans to the distressed farmers. I know that this is not the only solution, but this will give the farmers that they are not left alone. The government is with them. That's what UPA government did with the motherly heart, waived 75,000 crores of loan along with some constructive measures. You boast of PM Kisan scheme, but you have not actually spent the 20,000 crore rupees that had been budgeted in 2018 and 19. Adding boost to the agriculture crisis, there is a delay in payment of Manrega wages for last 6 months in many states, including Tamil Nadu. The senior citizens, women and differently abled were in tears when I met them in my constituency for not getting their wages for months. This is inhuman, the least I can say. Still, the budgetary allegation of Manrega has been reduced to 9,500 crores. Every day, we the women are facing heinous crimes, rape, and we are battling for our safety. Still, every time the Prime Minister, which is always vocal in Twitter, like social media platform like Twitter, is silent. Unfortunately, the Nirbhaya fund neither increased nor adequately spent. This shows the callous attitude of this government towards women's safety. I'd like to know from this government how much of funds from Save the Daughter, Save the Education scheme were used for our advertisement of our Honorable PM. The PM used to make a big show up for bringing back black money. Now he doesn't even talk about it. Instead, this government promotes the fair and lovely scheme of electoral funds, which get credited whooping 2,410 crore rupees to the BJP account, while the common man is suffering due to lack of income. Sir, I'm coming to my conclusion. Instead of taking this country towards the growth path, this government going astray with the divisive apps like CAA, NRC, and NPA. This is not the first time some government is giving asylum to the refugees of many prosecution. Congress government has been given ages, but we haven't discriminated anybody based on religious, race, and the country. We are opposing this government discriminate against Muslims and the Sri Lankan Tamils. The Sri Lankan Tamils, there are two generations of youth born and brought up here. When you say the minorities, the other religious, seven religion which you mentioned, prosecuted in neighboring countries, only three neighboring countries, we have seven neighboring countries, are not eligible to get the citizenship. What the Tamil people has done to you? Why you are discriminating Sri Lankan Tamil in this law? Then there is a census due in this year. This will give all the necessary data for the government. And there is an Aadhaar and voter ID, numerous other identities. Then why you need an NRC? This creates a species in the people mind. These acts have caused a lot of social unrest. We've been calling from the people from the government, Goli Marago. We can't raise the unemployment youth temper to create violence. This is not go down well with this any economy or anything. This social unrest will further adversely affect the economy. I'd like to end my speech with an apt Thirukural by our great Tamil poet Thiruvalluvar. Of late, the Treasury Benches has developed a lot of love for Thiruvalluvar. Though the Prime Minister is from Tamil Nadu, we are getting only Thirukural, nothing else. Ikalirki edesai the lakam, adhanai, mihalukin ukumam kedu, meaning shrinking away from hatred, will yield wealth. Indulging in increase of it will hasten ruin. I stand opposed the budget. Thank you.
Thank you, Jyothimani. Honorable Member Srimathi Rita Baguna Joshi.
Thank you very much, sir, for giving me this opportunity to speak on Union Budget 2020-21. Sir, I am very much sorry to say that I could not find any concrete ideas, announcement in this budget. The speech of Madam Finance Minister was only long and rhetoric, but short on substance. The budget is compromised, piecemeal measures, repackaged schemes, jugglery of dark slabs, and has no real solution to solve the economic crisis. Sir, we often say that the way of development of India goes through villages, and also the Indian economy needs higher rural incomes and demand. But government is doing exactly the opposite. The total centrally sponsored scheme allocation of rural India is rupees 120,147.19, which is less than the revised estimate of the previous year that comes to around 1,22,649 crore. The Union Government slashed budgetary allocation for its flagship MNREGA in the budget 2020-21 at a time when rural India is facing all sorts of crises, including rising food bills and the highest unemployment in the last 5 decades. India currently has the highest rate of unemployment, and the budget is coming at a time when the country is witnessing unemployment rate at 45-year high. And in her speech, Finance Minister acknowledged that by 2030, India will have the largest working population. The question then is, who will give jobs these new entrants? The budgetary allocation for centrally sponsored welfare schemes, including those for old age, disability and widows, pension was either slashed or remained static. The allocation of Indira Gandhi National Old Age Pension Scheme was 6,259 crore, a deduction by rupees 42 crore from revised estimate. The budgetary allocation for the National Family Benefit Scheme remained the same as the revised estimate, rupees 622 crore. This year, Panchayat Raj allocation was rupees 9,000 crore, which is a minimal increase from 871 crore in 2019-20. The revised estimation shows that the government has spent only rupees 500 crore. One of the 16 action points presented by the Madam Finance Minister in Parliament focused on the blue economy. Madam Finance Minister's speech was not reflected in the allocations made for the Union Ministry of Fisheries. Animal husbandry and dairying, the most awaited issues of goods and service tax on nets and fishing equipment, still no relief has been provided so far. Another bone of contention in the categorization of fish frames, which the Finance Minister talked about in her speech, but there is a difference between traditional seagoing fisherfolk and fish frames. More than 10 million traditional fisherfolk in the country were suffering as the government continued to push money into port projects in like Sagarmala in the name of blue economy. In October 2019, found that only 25% farmers in the country received all three installments in the first year of the scheme. The scheme was designed in a way that all farmers would not receive all three installments. The 16-point action plan is not going to cover more than 10% farmers of the country. The budget also reduced the subsidy of chemical fertilizers, which is going to impact productivity as sir. I request to government to provide an airport under regional connectivity scheme, Udaan scheme, which is need of the hour. Sir, more than 12 lakh people from southern states of like Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Karnataka, Andhra, working in abroad like Dubai, Kuwait, Muscat, Saudi Arabia. They send gifts, household items for their friends, relatives, kith and kins, according the norms allowed by Government of India. Either the value of custom duty, free gifts, household items were rupees 20,000, later to only rupees 5,000. Now it has been zero. My humbly request to kindly give the value and fix it now rupees 20,000, so that the gift items sent by the persons who live in abroad would meet their kith and kins on time. In the budget 2020-21, Madam Finance Minister proposed to reduce the time of stay in India of NREs from 180 days to 120 days. That is not good. I would like to bring your kind notice that a large number of Tamilian and Keralites migrated to Gulf countries and other countries are doing business there. They are frequently visits to India to look after their families. They propose to reduction in the number of days of stay in India will adversely affect them. I request to Madam Finance Minister to stop the reduction in
Lord,
days.
Please conclude. Okay.
Being Rameswaram pilgrimage place and tourists visiting in huge numbers, we need to develop the place as fast as to manage the tourists with all facilities. Hence, we request you to kindly release more funds to complete the work faster. In Rameswaram, there is a lot of NRI people. Ramanavaram, there is a lot of NRI people and businessmen who generate revenue in the district. So we need to plan nationalized base
yes.
in all major places.
Thank you, Namaskar. Okay.
Sir.
Please, conclude.
Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana is work under.
Final point.
Okay. The population of Muslim minority is more than 25% in Ramanavaram, but there is no central sponsored institution. I request to
yes.
open a branch Aliyar Muslim University in Magan. At last, I would like to request the government needs to step in investment in infrastructure to create
Sri
demand
DNB
for the
Sendil
core
Kumari.
Sector like cement, steel, building materials, and power, and create millions of jobs each year to absorb the
Thank you.
Vanakkam Speaker, thank you for this opportunity. This budget is seen as an anti-poor budget. It is because of MGNREGA schemes which have been going to the accounts of the poorest of the poor. The funding has been reduced to less than 10,000 crores has been reduced from the total funding. This budget is seen as an anti-people because of disinvestment of public sector units. Like for the wrongdoing of the government in taking to put the economy on growth, you go and disinvest the profitable agencies, the number one insurance companies like life insurance companies. This government is seen as a, this budget is seen as an anti-farmers interest because it doesn't address the distress of the farmers. There's nothing mentioned about the farmers' loan waiver. This budget is seen as an anti-Swachh Bharat because the amount of funds that are given are not implemented well. For example, in Uttar Pradesh, 540 crores was funded to sanctioning of 45 lakh toilets. But miraculously, the 45 lakh toilets have disappeared. This budget is seen as an anti-social justice budget because when the government says they want to bring in education, Asian and African students from outside and give studies over here, what about the student, girl students? The finance minister has proudly told that we have an enrollment of more girls in the primary education of more than 90%. But when it comes to the higher secondary, we have less than 40%. How are we going to address this issue? This government is seen as an anti-development government because the 10 railway schemes have been sanctioned in Tamil Nadu. But the total amount given for those 10 schemes is just rupees 10,000. That is rupees 1,000 per scheme. Is it a joke? How can 1,000 rupees be given for a project? The Honorable Railway Minister Piyush had come to Dharmapuri during the elections and given an election manifesto and during the foundation stone laying between Marpur and Dharmapuri had sanctioned 360 crores. And now you're just sanctioning 10 crores. How are we to go meet the electorates? I humbly request the Finance Minister and the Railway Minister to release the funds for the functioning of Marpur Dharmapuri lane. And this budget is also seen as an anti-Tamil and anti-Tamil Nadu. Because when they mention about the Keeladi, the archaeological sites are not given importance where the carbon dating of the Tamil language has been dated as the oldest and classical language of more than 2600 years, but nothing has been done to even give a small mention about Kiladi, because it establishes the credibility of Tamil, which is the oldest living language, oldest language in the world. And then they call this Hindu civilization, they give it a communal color, they call it as Sindhu Saraswati. I hope in future they don't call Kiladi as Vishnu Kiladi or some other sort of it. And this, even for AIIMS in Madurai, just the amount of sanction which have been done, nothing has been done. And whatever funding has been done so far has been through Japan-aided JICA. And there's no allotment of funds from the central government. We would like the AIIMS project to be taken off at Madurai at a very fast rate. And the funding which comes to the state is mostly from the southern states of Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Andhra, and Tamil Nadu, Karnataka. So this money which goes to the center, but the funding after the return which comes back to the state is a very meager amount. And there's always a stepmotherly treatment of funding towards the southern states. I hope this will be taken care of. And to conclude, sir, saying that I don't know from where the finance minister derives the figures and numbers from to make up this sort of thing. They say a 10% GDP. I don't know what limits them to just bring it to a 10% GDP. You can't even bring it to a 20% GDP, because anyway the numbers are not going to be reachable. So I don't know why you all restrict to that. Thank you. Thank you very much.